There is no reason anymore not to run Windows 10 Pro retail version on your PC. Get it now, $12.50 only, instant delivery on a brand new secured web store. If you look at this footage, you might think this is a brand new open world exploration game. Could have been, but it's not. This is Manor Lords, a strategy game based in the medieval area, and it's based on Unreal Engine 4, as you can see. So Unreal Engine 4 really is very versatile when it comes to game design. Not only shooters or third-person action games, also strategy games can be created with the wonderful tools of Unreal Engine 4. When it comes to strategy games, it seems they are getting forgotten more and more, and that's of course that strategy games are a little bit more of a niche in a niche area than any other genres. They of course were very popular back in the 90s, the Zeros as well, but nowadays, even if you look at these titles, which were pretty good titles from 2019, 2020, maybe Warcraft 3 Reforged might need to, may not be included on this list, but for the rest, the other titles were not bad. But the thing is, strategy games, they don't get the attention anymore that they used to have 10 or 20 years ago. Also, personally, I didn't really care much for strategy games, but when I saw this, and with the music and the wonderful atmosphere, it reminds me a lot of Kingdom Come Deliverance, and I just want to build peacefully some villages with a city builder like this. Maybe avoid combat at all, and I'm pretty sure that's going to be possible in Manor Lords. The game will first be featured in Early Access so that the publisher will get the funding he needs to finish the project. From what I understood, the publisher's Slavic Magic is just a single guy from Poland who is currently hiring freelancers to do music and asset stuff. So I really hope he do gets the funding he needs while this is on Steam Early Access. Because if he needs to go to investors, usually they don't give full free playing space. You know, they want to have deadlines, and usually it doesn't really help the project that much unless you can make some clear agreements on funding and stuff like that. So I hope this game will release in the state that he had in mind for this game. I know a lot of ambitious projects usually end up because of the funding. So I really hope the best for this project, because I am really looking forward to the first early access, the green light status on Steam. So when we check the website of Manor Lords, you can see the features, but on top of that, the tech behind it really shows how versatile Unreal Engine 4 is with the motion capture. Here you can see the standard models from Unreal Engine 4, but also the photogrammetry in combination with Quixel Mega Scans. And I know how easy they are to implement inside a project. So it's a very good choice I think the author made with Unreal Engine 4 Quixel Mega Scans. And it means that even if you are an independent developer with one or a couple of guys, you are able to do the level design very easy, very good quality assets for Quixel Mega Scans. So that's very amazing. So to show you a little bit what Quixel is able to offer, they have all these collections. So an example, if you would check out this environment, you are able to use all these materials, all these assets, all these photogrammetry scanned assets directly in your project. You can, as far as I understand, with Quixel Bridge, literally just drag and drop them into your project. And also when I check an example castle, for this game, there are a lot of these structures, these textures, which are all photo scanned and all able to use directly in the project. So that's why I think this guy is able to do it by its own so far, with the help of some freelancers maybe to do the level design or knows the scripting. So that's pretty cool that that since Unreal has bought Quixel Mega Scans, that you are able to use all these assets. And I thought only if your project is about to earn more than 50,000 or $1 million, one of the two it was, then you are going to pay some royalties. Else, it's all to use for free. So if you like to create something in Unreal Engine 4, but you don't have any assets or textures or whatever, check out Quixel Mega Scans to have great looking photo scanned assets. And no, this is not a promotional video for either Manor Lords or Unreal Engine 4, but I really love the technology and the availability that we have. But the best thing is that the publisher itself has an explanation video on YouTube what this project is and what you can expect when you're actually going to play the game. So I thought it would be nice to end this video with their official trailer that you have a little bit of an idea what you can expect. So thanks for watching so far and enjoy the rest of this video with the official trailer.
Welcome to Manor Lords.
Let's get to work!
In this video, I'd like to introduce you to some of the core mechanics of the game, including regional development, trade, and military recruitment.
We need more workers here!
The map in Manor Lords is divided into regions. Each region has its own resources, as well as a development tree. When you upgrade the residential buildings in the region, you get development points, which you can spend to unlock new development branches. This means that different regions may specialize in different things. Some may be more optimized for farming, some for mining. And some will process the resources to make expensive goods, like shoes or clothing. Depending on the optimization of your production chains, the price of the goods will change, affecting the market attractiveness. Free merchants will travel more frequently to towns that have rare and more affordable goods. These merchants are the only way to get wealth in the game. Lord's treasury, however, is split from the regional wealth. As the lord or lady, you must tax your towns and villages in order to get money for your personal endeavors. There are different taxes giving various benefits. For example, the tithe goes straight to the church, but in return, the church gives you influence. Every so often, the king gives out valuable rewards to the most influential lords on the map, including new territories. You can compliment or insult other lords via the diplomacy system to affect their influence. The recruitment system in Manor Lords has been redesigned after some community feedback. It is now divided into three unit categories. First type of recruits are the peasant militia. You can call to arms the peasants from your villages. They grab whatever improvised weapons they have and join the fight.
War is coming!
This will hit your economy, and you'll need at least a couple of villages to form an army. If you want better militia, you must train them at the training camp or the archery range. The second type of recruits are mercenaries. They cost silver and a lot of it. The last type is Lord's Retinue. This is a limited, heavily armored unit that you can customize to your liking. Thank you for joining in for this short preview of Manor Lords gameplay systems. If you're interested in discussing the game, be sure to visit Manor Lords Discord and subreddit. See you all in the next video.